Words don't mean a Cause up your sleeve you got a brand of magic never fails. You got power in your corner now. Heavy ammunition in your can. You got some punch for sand. And now all you gotta do is love that thing. And then I say, Mr. Man, what's your name? Whatever your pleasure be. Let me take your corner, I'll jot it down. You ain't never had a friend like me. Life is your restaurant, and I'm your maid to be. We find ourselves on service. You the boss, we can't be shy. Say what you wish, it's yours to dish. I'd rather let him on my river. Have some of Calumet, try all of Calumby. I'm thinking to help you do. You ain't never had a friend like me.
Thank you. was dedicated in 1886, dating by New York Harbor, my eyes have seen a timeline of history, from the local ferry to the international airplane.
What have you seen?
I saw the New York skyline, dwelling the garden of skyscrapers, including the Empire State Building, and the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center. Now I cry. Never forget 9/11.
Never forget 9/11. But why?
Just listen to the radio flashback, and imagine you see what I saw.
Flashback. This is WHY Radio with the up-to-minute news. At 8:46 this morning, September 11th, 2001, an airplane jet crashed into the North Tower of the World Trade Center in New York. The tower blazes with smoke billowing.
Evacuations are underway. Emergency personnel are responding. No details are not concerned with the cause of the crash. Stay tuned and keep you updated.
I saw the jet crash into the side of the North Tower of New York's World Trade Center, 2001, and I cried. Lady Liberty couldn't stop the attack.
What do you mean, the attack?
This is WHY Radio. In case you missed it, at 8:46 this morning, September 11, 2001, a jet hit the North Tower of the New York's World Trade Center. One tower of the Twin Towers is burning, with smoke rising like a dark cloud.
Another plane is at the South Tower. There's just been another explosion at the second tower.
I saw the second jet crash into the side of the second tower at 9:03 in the morning of September 11, 2001, and I wept. Lady Liberty felt helpless. The Twin Towers were filled with thousands of people, and thousands more were on the street going to work. There was no warning.
This is WHY Radio with today's news. The Twin Towers of the New York World Trade Center are both burning now. It appears to be an act of terrorism, not an accident.
Sirens are blasting, and emergency personnel are helping as much as they can. People were running all over.
I watched first responders enter the burning building. Firemen, policemen, and rescue workers all ignored the danger to their own lives in order to save the lives of others. We honor them, and we will never forget.
We will never forget.
Flashback, this is WHY Radio with the latest news. The United States of America appears to be under attack. Besides the two planes hitting the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center in New York, the Pentagon in Washington, D.C., representing the nation's military, was just hit by a different jet at 9:43 this morning, September 11, 2001.
No details are available. According to witnesses, the jet seemed to disappear to the side of the building. Rescue workers are again on scene. Evacuations are in progress.
I didn't see the jet crash into the Pentagon, but I can imagine the plane flying low over the river and the road. The Pentagon is not a tower. The plane would have to fly low. My heart aches for this nation and the world.
This is WHY Radio. Ladies and gentlemen, a fourth jet has veered off course and appears to be heading to the Washington, D.C. area. Perhaps the White House. Evacuations of government buildings are underway.
I heard the cries of fear in New York. City walls echoed voices of panic. We're at war. More planes are coming. Run, hide. Other side. Oh God, help us. I mourn the loss of life.
Flashback. This is WHY Radio with the latest news. The South Tower of the World Trade Center has just collapsed, less than an hour after it was hit by a hijacked jet. There's a huge cloud of dust, ash, chasing people on the street. People were running through the smoke and black debris, but it's impossible to outrun the wind.
I saw the South Tower of the World Trade Center being built, 110 stories. I saw it all fall, 110 stories crumbled. People were trapped in the rubble. I knew someone survived. This is a nation of survivors, built from many nations of survivors.
We are survivors.
Flashback. In a strange turn of events, hijacked flight 93 that appeared to be heading toward Washington, D.C. just crashed at 10:06 this morning in a Pennsylvania field.
We don't know the details. Perhaps some passengers became heroes trying to intercept the hijackers before they reached Washington, D.C. Stay tuned for the latest on 9/11.
I saw heroes on 9/11. Some entered burning buildings to save people. Some sent warnings. Some protected women, children, the elderly, and the disabled.
Never forget the heroes of 9/11.
Two hijacked airplanes crashed into each of the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center this morning. The South Tower collapsed with smoke of ash, debris, and smoke rolling down the streets. The North Tower is still burning.
We interrupt this broadcast for up to the minute news. The burning North Tower of the World Trade Center has just collapsed, ladies and gentlemen, in another cloud of smoke, ash, and debris.
I was in shock, like so many others in New York City and around the globe on 9/11. People fled toward me. They offered hope. This is a nation of overcomers, built from many nations of overcomers.
We are overcomers.
It's still 9/11, perhaps one of the worst days in history. The rubble of the New York Twin Towers still burns, smoke curls up into the empty skyline. The crashed hijacked plane. still burns in the Pennsylvania field.
Meanwhile, the Pentagon, Washington, D.C., still burns where four hijacked planes crashed inside the building. This just in, a section of the Pentagon where the plane crashed has also collapsed. This is a very sad day for America. A very sad day for the world.
Being a statue, I really couldn't think about that all day. But United States President George Bush did. He was with some school children when he fled the news of the attack. And just some of the words presented to the nation.
These are acts of mass murder, were intended to frighten our nation into chaos and retreat, but they have failed. Our country is strong. A great people has been moved to defend a great nation. Terrorist attacks can shake the foundation of the biggest building, but they cannot touch the foundation of America. America is targeted for attack because we're the brightest beacon for freedom and opportunity in the world, and no one will keep that light from shining.
I hold my torch up proudly for freedom.
I thank the many world leaders who have called to offer their condolences and assistance. America and her friends and allies join with all those who want peace and security in the world.
The impact on families reached around the globe. The attacks killed nearly 3,000 people from 93 nations.
Unfortunately, 2,753 people were killed in New York.
Plus, 84 people were killed at the Pentagon. Killed in Flight 93 that crashed.
Never forget.
For all those who grieve, for the children whose world has been shattered, for all whose sense of safety and security has been threatened, I pray they will be comforted by a power greater than any of us, spoken through the ages in Psalm 23. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me.
Never forget.
This is a day when all Americans, from every walk of life, unite in our resolve for peace and justice. None of us will ever forget this day.
We honor our rescue workers.
We honor the heroes of Flight 93.
We honor all who helped on 9/11.
And we honor all the lives lost in this tragedy.
Never, never forget 9/11.
We will never forget.
I talk to God. greatest is the love. The greatest is the love. The greatest is the love. Where were you when the world stopped turning on that September day?
Without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all. standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. Not talk about family when family's all that we got. Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
Been a long way without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. You've come a long way from where we began.
Go, we started.
No, I'm not. big one new game is self-care. Since quarantine, there's been a trend for self-care. Self-care, not just mentally and physically, you see, but often we deal with your own stuff. It turns into an emergency. But this next one, I'm gonna warn you all. You gotta take your ears to the emergency room. Fair warning.
Yeah. Do I have your attention?
y'all gonna sing y'all's name? That's not how people. But for those of you that, I appreciate it. Well, thank you. I'm loving compliments. I'm loving it. Line Officer Natalie and Special Officer Madison, I bring you a piece of Flex Dean, there for each other. Through thick and thin, it creates a heart that feels like home and a sisterhood. Enjoy.
Thank you. Ladies, I think it's time to switch roles.
Switch up the world.
I'm back to Grace Jones for the message, you know, just hug out in the time. Alright, now, see what Natalie got planned for y'all. Before I let you do it, I'll tell y'all something about Natalie. See, Natalie's a soldier, you know what I mean? Natalie's someone you can talk to at any time, to anyone. It's like talking to a brick wall, but the brick wall will occasionally laugh, and then, like, say, yeah, I feel you. It's like talking to a brick wall, and then occasionally, she'll be like, yeah, you want some water out here, bud? Just take some holes. Well, she's been a rock for me and all my other friends. You know, love it too. And she's getting this song because it depicts that it's the person she is. It's the person she has been and continues to be. So, give y'all that idea.
I never had nobody, no road home. I wanna meet somebody to song.
Talk about. Now, before I say this, I don't have any opinion on this. Whether you like him, you really don't like him, he's our president. But this is nothing we all agree on. He's hilarious. Joseph R. Biden, I'm sorry. He starts all of his conversations with a question. And then, he malfunctions a little bit after. And then he starts again with another question. Now, we all have Ukraine drama going on. All those people. Sad case. But I was watching this one interview, and then a reporter at this female, of course, she goes, Mr. President, where's your relationship with Vladimir Putin? He replies, yes. Just a thought. I will. Thank you. speaking of women, who's the change of minds? Who'll be announcing the silent auction winners? I'm positive that's what we'll be doing.
Closer to the end of the dance, but sit tight and let's welcome the new team.